Hi, this is Who Cares, and here's my review of The Batman. And this is our first Batman solo movie since 2012 with The Dark Knight Rises. I know people are going to say, how about Batman v Superman? Technically, that is a sequel to Man of Steel. And I know that feels like more a Batman film, mostly, but it is a Man of Steel sequel. And also, he's in, you know, the Justice League, whatever it is you want to watch, you know, the Zack Snyder, or, you know, the... what do I mean? But this is our main Batman movie. And, yeah, I love it. Now, before I go and say what I like about the film, what I hate about the film, I will give you a little plot of it. And this will be spoilers free, and yet near the end I will say a bit of spoilers, but I will put a timestamp on that. So basically the plot is that all the politicians getting murdered by this man, and, you know, one by one, and they find out this man is, you know, the Riddler, and basically each victim he killed got like a shady past. You know, either a dirty politician or a dirty peace officer, basically, you know, taking bribes, doing, you know, name it, it's there. And Batman is, and, you know, he got to work out this mystery. And basically, it's a mystery filler. Most of the time, it's a mystery filler. Yeah, there's some action in it, but most of the time, it's a mystery filler. And be honest, I actually like that for a change for the Batman movies. Because, again, I'm not saying this is the best one, where I go into that near the end, but all the Batman movies, it all action packed. Yeah, did a bit of mystery in them, but this one is more mystery than action from beginning to end in the film. So, basically, that is the twists and turns, the truth he finds out, and basically, it comes to the showdown with the Riddler. Basically. Now, before I get, you know, into the spoilers bit, I want to say what I like about this film. First off, it's, yeah, like I said, it's a very, he's not a Batman fan. This is a very, very good mystery thriller film to us. As, you know, there's a good mystery in it. And they found that, you know, why he's doing it. You actually think, yeah, it's quite good. The writing is quite very good in this, with twists and turns, and the acting, first of all, Robert Pattinson as, you know, Bruce Wayne and Batman, yeah, he sold the show. He was unbelievable in this. And just to think, they feel now that he's gonna be Batman, a lot of people said they had doubts, think he's gonna be crap. And the thing is, I did have a bit of doubt in my head, but at the same time, I learned my lesson from, you know, The Dark Knight Returns with Keith Ledger. Because then that got broken out, everyone was freaking out, including me. I thought, really, Keith Ledger going to play the Joker? And then the movie came out, and we all know what happened. He became one of the best Jokers out there. And again, before I say, I'm not saying this Robert Pattinson is the best Batman, I'm not. Because it's too early to say that, because technically, you only have one film. You got all the Batmans, you have more than one film, technically, so I can't say he's the best Batman, but what he does in this film, he sold the show, and he done the part unbelievable. And the Penguin, God, yeah, the Penguin is very good. Again, he's not in the movie much, but I actually like this Penguin, what he's doing with, and with the wake news that he's going to do a spin-off series for him. I'm looking forward to it. I'm on board with it. And again, a couple of days ago they announced it. I thought, oh, really? And they are now watching this film after seeing a handful of scenes, you know, Penguin's in. Yeah, I want to see more of him. I think he is a very well-told character. Yeah, there's no backstory for him. But again, maybe this is what the spin-off series might do for him. So, yeah. And of course, I do want to talk about the Riddler, but I want to say that in my spoilers bit. Okay? And Catwoman? Yeah, I thought she's fine. But I still prefer the Anne Hathaway one. And again, I'm not doing cause weight or that, I'm not. I don't know. I think I need to see him one more time to say, is he good? Yeah, he's done a fine job. I'm not saying she hasn't, but compared to Anne Hathaway, I do like Anne Hathaway a bit more as Catwoman. So now I got, and before I go to my doubts, got this one of the doubts is spoilers technically. It's a bit of a spoiler, you know what I mean? But I want to put a timestamp here to, if you haven't watched it, you want to, you know, skip to the final force. Fine. Krogu, get a timestamp here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Now, what that I got. The first nerves that I got, and again, I don't be into the left and right side anyway. I think both sides are over the top. But the thing is, there's a bit in the movie where Catwoman, there's a line in the movie is like, really? Know what I mean? Why? Know what I mean? Is him and Batman talking, and then basically she says, I want to bring down the white people down. Or white defenses, no, really one of those, and I'm thinking, really? And again, I'm not going to the waste war, I'm not going to wet or white, but my problem is the whole movie does not cover racism at all. If it did, fine, put it in if you want, but there's no racism in it, it doesn't fit at all. And it felt off, you know what I mean? Because again, she could have said the white. She don't know why. She always said these monsters, these corrupt pigs. Know what I mean? It would have been the same thing, but they just use racism. It's like, really? There's no racism in this. Know what I mean? For fix sake, we got a covert, you know, actor to play Gordon, which I think he done a fantastic job. Know what I mean? I forgot to mention that Gordon in this is a very good Gordon. And again, I'm not bothered what color who's playing. I'm not bothered about wasting messages, I'm not. But it makes sense to the film, and the film fit that theme, and this film do not fit the theme of racism. It fits our corrupts and you know, that's it, politics and being corrupt, or people high power being corrupt. That's what this film theme is about. And another theme, the message, I meant on a good bit on the spoilers in a minute, where there's a message in this too. That's the whole point of this film. And the length, that's my other thing. It can be a bit, you can drag a bit long near the end. Again, not too bad compared to other films. Now, the positive on the spoilers, like I said, there's a mess at the end of the film, which is a very good message. Then you find out the twist about the Widower, what he'd done and why he'd done it. Is he got a messed up backstory where he's an orphan and Bruce's dad, you know, cock up here, so he died, and then they got a chance to fix it. And so he blamed him, and he blamed the Corpson of him not getting a good home, him, you know, having a fucked up like childhood. And basically, the message of the what he said, this is the message of the film, basically. He followed Batman because Batman messes, even beginning the film, he says he want vengeance, he want people to be scared of him, to make fear out of him, so he won't do crime, and he wanted to do the same, but he takes it to the next level with terrorism, with, you know, name it. And basically the message is for Batman, it really is, he is making the anti-heroes, you know, the over top anti-heroes who, you know, I think they're heroes but they're not heroes. So yeah, I think that is a real good message for the dog, for Batman. And I think, yeah, I know it's been done before, but this delivers so well with this. Okay, we'll get to the final thoughts. So here's my final thought of the Batman. And before I get right into it, or answer multiple questions, is this the best Batman movie? At the moment now, no. That could change one I've seen multiple times in the future. Like, I'm definitely going to buy it on physical, no matter what. But after watching it multiple times, that could change my mind. But at the moment, now I still think The Dark Knight is the better one. Yeah, there's faults with that too. I'm not saying there isn't. There's faults with The Dark Knight. But to me personally, that film I love from beginning to end, even though he got fault in it. Now, about Robert Pattinson being the best Batman, and again, same thing again, I can't say yes or no on that one, because technically you only have one film, and you can't say he's the best Batman after one film. I mean, what Michael Keaton, Christian Bale, he had at least two or more films. Michael Keaton had two films, and meanwhile Warwick had, you know, three. So I can't say, you know, oh, he's the best Batman. And the same with Ben Affleck, he had two movies, he made multiple appearances. He had two main movies and a couple of handful of appearances, you know what I mean? And again, I'm not saying he's the best, he's not the best one. But then, you know, Batman v Superman came out, I did fell in love with that Batman, because it's more like an angrier Batman we got on a movie form. I know comics, we got that in comics, but in movie form, this is like the angriest Batman we got, you know what I mean, on movies, on live action movies. Now, my score of the film, again, I'm not going to knock it down too much because of two things, like the length of the film, where it drags in the end. Again, it's not that bad compared to other films, so I'm not going to pick on that. And like I said before about Catwoman saying about white preferences, you know what I mean, or, you know what I mean, white peers, you know, being raised into this, which don't fit to be in the movie. Again, I'm not going to bring that down because technically it's only like 5 seconds, you know what I mean. I will be like, if I knock down to like, oh, you know, a lot of points down to focus that one line, is like, really? I'm being petty if I've done that, know what I mean? So, technically, I'm not going to give the horse for that, know what I mean? Even though that line was stupid, it didn't make sense for that thing in the movie, because again, it's been waste fine, put it in, but there's no waste in this, know what I mean? If they talk Gordon, because we didn't think Gordon is good, know what I mean? If we talk Gordon being, you know, waste attack on Gordon, I'd say fine, maybe put it in, but again, even then, it can't put it in. And again, before people say I'm racist, I'm not. I thought the person he played, I put his name on the comment there. I thought he played unbelievable well. And I actually like this Gordon, to be honest with you. He's a bad, to be honest, come season, he's a badass in this too, so I actually like him, you know what I mean? So, I'm not bothered. And it's a film, if he'd done a Batman film that's done with racism, I wouldn't have been bothered either, because I think, whatever, I don't care what the mess, wrong, the mess makes sense, and, you know, the theme there, I think, yeah. And the problem with that one line, it didn't fit the whole theme, because the whole, what I said in the before, the whole theme about corruption is about, you know, deep politics and deep up people with high power like the police, all that. There's no theme of, you know, racism, there's no scenes that show, like, you know, people getting beat up because they're race, you know what I mean? So, and again, I'm not going to knock down for that. I'm not, because again, technically it's only 5 seconds, you know what I mean? So, if I'm going to rank this, it's a 9 out of 10. It's a must see. Like I said, even if not a Batman fan, it's a very good Mitty filler, you know, from beginning to end. There's not a lot of action. There's action in it, but compared to other Batman films, this to me got the least action in it, because like I said, it is a Mitty filler. And I think years ago, they got announced that way going with, and I think he delivered well on this. I think the director would do very well on what he said to do, making like a Mitty filler style movie, and he done that a good job on that. So I say it's a 9 out of 10. So that's it now. That's my review done. Leave a comment below on what you thought of this movie. Do you like the movie or you hate the movie? And again, people got different opinions. I understand both opinions. If you like it or you don't like it, again, people got different tastes. And if you like the review, give a like, or you go to see more reviews like this, subscribe to my channel. So, this has been the Brit Who Cares. See you on the next one.